Dr. Michael Eric Dyson with us tonight, Georgetown University professor and MSNBC political analyst. And also with us tonight, Mike Papantonio, Ring of Fire radio host. Gentlemen, great to have you with us tonight. Michael, you first. What is A&E Network? What are they saying here? What statement are they making by reversing this decision?
Well, as you've brilliantly articulated, Ed, what they're saying is that black people and gay people don't count. They don't matter to the bottom line. They don't figure in our calculations about what we think is offensive. And as a result of the Cracker Barrel crowd, that crowd that said, look, we are disgusted with you for removing the items of Phil Robertson and Duck Dynasty. We are, moreover, disgusted with the fact that African-American and Latino and other ethnic minorities, along with gay, lesbian, transgender, and bisexual people have come together to say this is an outrage, and as a result of that, they have turned this into a matter of free speech. The irony, of course, is that they don't want more speech to counteract their negative, vicious, offensive, and vitriolic speech. So they're mad at the fact that we are challenging what they're saying, and then we don't have the right to free speech. A&E has made the calculation that African-American people and gay people don't matter not only to their bottom line, but won't raise as hard a ruckus as the right wing will, and those who are very supportive of the Duck Dynasty are the very people who need that insight. And by the way, Ed, what's interesting, the right wing has said, look, the grandson of Mr. Robertson happens to be an adopted biracial child. What difference does that make? The man who plunged a plunger deep into the behind of Abner Louima was himself dating a black woman when he did that heinous act. So there's no one-to-one correlation between a particular domestic intimacy with a black person or a person of color and the behavior that you manifest that is either just or unjust. So all of this stuff is being brought up as a result of this.
Mike, this was just a big calculation on their part, wasn't it? Or do you see it differently? I mean, the only color they see right now is green.
Yeah, Daddy Duck and all the little ducks, first of all, are not actually reality in Duckville. They're highly produced, highly promoted brands that created by A&E. And in spite of all the holy-mouthed apologies we're hearing from their multi-million dollar executives, they want this 50 Shades of Crazy, this moonbat talk unleashed on the screen because, yes, it does divide America, but, Ed, it divides America in a way to where they can still make money from that part that they're going after. The only people who believe that Daddy Duck's oddball behavior is all spontaneous are the same people who believe that world wrestling is real. It's simply a highly profitable brand. It's a commodity that producers and directors help invent. And the very fact that Daddy Duck has made statements suggesting that gays hate God, that Shindu Japanese are Nazis, and that African Americans were simply attending a big happy Lollapalooza party when they were slaves. All that is exactly the kind of low life trash talk that A&E producers have been cultivating for years. They're the ones who help set up the scenes, Ed. They create this low trash gutter talk, and that's what they want. It sells more time on television.
And Mike Dyson, doesn't this somewhat signal that there's a portion of America that is never going to accept diversity, that there is a portion of America that's always going to have a jaded view? Also, Robertson, I understand, recently said in an interview that 15-year-old girls should have a Bible in their hand and that they should just stay home and have children. I mean, I find it, this is part of their selling point, isn't it?
Well, it's retrograde, it's retroactive, and what they're trying to do is to keep a number of people in their places, a number of genders in their places. This is a real, what they call Manichaean division. That's a big word to suggest. There's us versus them. It's the rest of the world versus them, and their belief system is rooted in and deeply entrenched in a belief that says that people should adhere to narrow provincial understandings of religion. To suggest that gay and lesbian people are somehow bestialities, engaging in bestial performances, and that black people were happy during slavery is to ignore the vicious indifference to black people and gay people, and it's also to perpetuate the legacy that as long as black people shut up and accept their plight and predicament in America, everything is fine. The moment they begin to stand up for themselves and to speak out against the kind of bigotry that's here, then all of a sudden they become problem makers and are divisive against the unity of America.
And the danger here is that the people that follow this kind of talk don't understand the division that they are creating in America and the insensitivity that's out there. But now if you've got enough people behind you, you have a license to do it in niche programming to influence even more people, which I think is dangerous. But, Mike, is this a win for the conservative media? I mean, I'll tell you what, they circled the folks on top of the hill and they charged fast on this one.
Well, they showed they could get it done when they focused. They showed that they really don't care, really. They don't care about the public opinion in a broad sense, Ed. The division, for example, that you're talking about, this is a division in America that's developed beyond simple politics, and they don't really care about it. It also shows a division that's developed in our religion, in our churches. Daddy Duck's divisive view of his religion takes a big black magic marker and crosses out, erases everything that's good and important about segments like Matthew in our Bible.
All right. Michael Eric Dyson, Mike Papantonio. Great to have you with us on The Ed Show. Thanks for all the work you've done with us this year. Have a great holiday, and we're back to you in 2014. Great to have you guys
happy
on.
New Year.